What's going on, everybody? It's your boy So Dip in there, and I am back with another video, guys. Like I told you guys in the beginning of this channel, I was going to start doing reviews on the Basketball Wives, and so I haven't been doing them because so much has been going on, and I wanted to evaluate this OG situation. And so I think at this point I'm able to do that, and so I want to get into that. Now, before we get into this video, guys, if you want to join my crew, you already know what to do. Go ahead and turn on notifications so that you get notified every time I post new videos. Subscribe to my channel so that you're a subscriber, you're a part of this channel. And also comment below, let me know what you guys think at any point of anything that I've talked about. Because what you guys think and what you guys say matters to me. And share these videos. You can record it, tag me in it, so people that are watching are able to track back to my channel. And, comment below, let me know what they think. Outside of people that are subscribed to my channel, hopefully that brings me new subscribers. So let's get into this video. So first off, we start off with Jennifer and Kristen talking on the phone. Jennifer is basically checking up on Kristen to find out how she felt about the whole OG and her conversation. They let it be known that, Jennifer lets it be known she's never really experienced any colorism, and that they are also the same color as well. So this kind of gives us some more insight into what's going on with this group of ladies, because again, like I said before, you know, I feel like Kristen and Jennifer are the same color as OG, but we have learned within the last few episodes that it's not just about the skin tone, it's also about features. And so I think this is really important for a lot of us, because when we're thinking about colors, we're just thinking about the color of the skin. We're not also thinking about features. Like, that's not in our minds. Colorism doesn't associate with features of your, you know, your face or your body or however that goes. And Jennifer lets Kristen know that she thought that it was dope that she was woman enough to come over and actually talk to OG, which again, I feel like that too. If you guys have saw me on All About the Tea, I've definitely expressed that I feel like what Kristen did was very genuine. I felt like her going over to the house with Jennifer, Jackie, and OG to find out what she's done, take responsibility for her own self, was very big of her. I thought that it was very responsible of her. And I think that genuinely she just wanted to know what has she done so that in the future it doesn't happen with anyone else. Again, OG didn't take it that way, but let's take a break outside of this episode really quick. So this is something I do want to say. I know a lot of you guys hate this show, but because you hate the show doesn't mean everything that's happening on the show is fake. And so we have to give these women the opportunity to express or to show their concern as to how OG, what OG experienced, because that's what she said. She said she didn't feel anything, she experienced it. So we have to give these women an opportunity to learn what OG experienced, because as black people, we are always in a space where people aren't educated on things that we've been through or what's offensive to us and what's not. Colorism is a very new thing for a lot of people, and I've seen it in the comments on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram. Colorism has been something that a lot of people have never even heard of. So to me, OG has a really good opportunity to show something that people may not have a lot of information on. And I really wish the OG would, but we'll get into that a little bit more. Let's keep going. Kristen tells Jennifer that, you know, none of the ladies really have an issue with her. And she wants her to come over to the house. And Jennifer is like, no, because the last time that she seen Shawnee told her that she wouldn't take a vacation with her. And I feel like this is a big problem in this group of women, is that they don't understand how to have a conversation about hard things. Like, if you say something, let's talk about it, because until we talk about it, I don't feel like it's been resolved. So I 100% agree with Jennifer. Like, if the last time I seen Shawnee and she's saying that she doesn't want to be around me, why would I feel like it's okay for me to be around again? And so I feel like Shawnee should take that into consideration and not blow Jennifer off as though, you know, just because you've moved on, you've never told Jennifer this. So Jennifer is in her right because she's respecting Shawnee's space and saying she doesn't want to be around her, so I'm not going to be around her. So after Kristen and Jennifer get off the phone, she's basically, Jennifer tells Kristen she has things to deal with in the people in her own house. And she does, because Jackie's not there for the bullshit at all. If you guys have seen the other episodes, Jackie is really not there for Jennifer's bullshit, in which I agree with Jackie with this, because Jennifer was very negative, like, don't bring this negativity back in this house. And Jackie is like, this is my house. I got this house for us to stay in. So if I want to bring the devil up in here naked, I'ma do it. And I think the same with everyone in the house. Jackie just wants to fix things. And I think because Jackie is a veteran in this show, she's been here where these ladies have been, maybe not in the colorism thing that OG's going through, but Jackie understands it. And honestly, I feel like Jennifer should understand it as well, because Jennifer's been on low to anybody. So I definitely feel Jackie's frustration when it's like, why do you guys keep holding on to all this stuff that's from the past? Like, this is a year and a half ago. People's minds have changed. And again, like I said, you know, Shawnee hasn't communicated with Jennifer, but none of these ladies have communicated with each other. So nobody knows what's going on. So again, I'm with Jackie. Like, I'm over it. Like, let's get this shit fixed. And if we can't, take your ass home. Jackie then reveals to Jennifer that she has some new ladies coming on. Nia and Naraya. One of those. Now, can we talk about Jennifer's confessional look? Because she had this little hat and it was going on like this, but it was like a little baby hat. And I just want to knock it off her head. Like, what is that, Jennifer? I don't know. Let's keep. So they switch over to the other house. Kristen lets them know that Jennifer basically says she's never experienced colorism in the group. And to me, I feel like if anybody has experienced it, it would have been Jennifer. So it's really good to hear that Jennifer's never experienced this. And even if she's not saying that it's that. You know what I'm saying? I think that that was one of the biggest things that I thought of watching this episode. Kristen also lets them know that Jennifer is basically not trying to deal with the group because of what Shawnee said. And again, like I said earlier, I feel like, you know, Shawnee's like, this is a year and a half ago, but within this year and a half, you've never told her that you're over it. So how does she know that? Like, you have to have a conversation. It doesn't work like that, Shawnee. And like, you are old enough to know that. So, yeah, I mean, the fact that they're all open to have her over there, with Jennifer having beef with Malaysia, Evelyn, and Shawnee, I would feel like Jennifer too. So I think that Jennifer is in her right to feel like she doesn't want to be around them, because it's going to be a negative situation. And none of these ladies have said, hey, you know, I'm over it. So Jennifer did the right thing. You guys below, let me know what you guys think. So Jackie and OG start having a conversation about Kristen coming over to the house, and basically the conversation that they had, OG's over it, and OG's over the conversation. She said she had to take more rest. She was coming down to make breakfast, I think, but she was over it because all the questions that Kristen had asked her. And to me, this is draining, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you, it's very draining. Because it's like OG just wants to stay upset. She doesn't want to fix anything. And that's my major problem with this. And I want to get more into this as this goes on. I'm just trying to give you guys a breakdown before we get to the real conversation. Malaysia decides that she does want to have a conversation with Jackie. Because Jackie took up for them. Well, for her, which I don't. Maybe it was like in the behind the scenes stuff that we didn't get to see, but Jackie basically said that the things that OG are saying that they called her, they've called everybody else. So Malaysia feels like that Jackie took up for her. So she kind of feels like Jackie took up for her, and she wants to have a conversation with Jackie to make peace, which Malaysia and Jackie do this all the time. So this is like nothing new. I'm glad that they're going to do it because I love Jackie and Malaysia's relationship. So I think that it's dope that Malaysia does want to make peace with Jackie. I just hope this is the last time because I'm sick of the back and forth between Jackie and Malaysia. So the two new ladies show up, Nia and Nerea. Basically, they're introduced into the house with Jackie, Jennifer, and OG. OG's making breakfast. Somebody burnt the croissants. And I love this moment because it was a really dope moment between those ladies. I love the fact that they burnt the croissants. And Jackie's like, give me one of burnt-ass croissants. You have to love Jackie for the comic relief and all this stuff because Jackie is, that's just who Jackie is. So I love it. These ladies come in. I just love their energy. I think that they are really dope women. And I can't wait to see how this goes on because we do later on that one of them dated Phoebe's baby's dad and it gets a little messy. But right now I'm loving these ladies and I think that they're going to add to this group of women. We learned that their father passed away from COVID. Rest in peace for that. And Jennifer and them actually make a bond because Jennifer's mother passed away a few years ago. And so they have that bond together, which I think is really good for Jennifer because she really hasn't had the support from this group of women. So I do think that this is a moment for Jennifer from other women that are joining the group. And I love this moment. And, you know, I do feel so sad for them that their father passed away from COVID. COVID has not been nice to a lot of us. So this is the part I really want to get into. So the ladies sit down for the dinner that OG made. And Jackie expresses to the ladies that, you know, there's a lot of beef between the ladies. And that Jennifer had a chance to talk to Kristen that morning. And Jennifer said that she felt like it was very noble of Kristen to come over to the house. OG interrupts this conversation. It's like, you never told me that I was noble. And to me, this is where the problem starts to come in at for me, again with OG, because it's like OG doesn't want to fix anything. And to me, it's giving me a hard time to have empathy for OG and any of this stuff, because this is the third conversation they've had about this. OG does not want to talk about this stuff. She's thrown these accusations out of here. And like, it's like, I've thrown it out, deal with it. Find out for yourself. But ma'am, you are on national television. And if you're going to throw out something like colorism, explain to the world what this means for people. Yes, I understand that you said you've explained this before. They didn't air it. But you have opportunity right now because these women are thrown for a loop at this point. They don't understand why OG is felt like this. You have Kristen, you have Jennifer, who are the same skin color as her. And she said, they haven't experienced it. OG did say, with the conversation with Kristen the last episode, that it's about features as well. But these are all learning moments for a lot of people that don't understand what OG is experiencing. And I feel like OG is being very irresponsible with this conversation because even with this, it's like, well, why are you, and it's almost like you don't know what to call OG because everything you call her is offensive. Because to me, I feel like she just attacked Jennifer by saying, well, you never called me noble. Why you, like, it was like, well, wait a minute now. I just don't understand it. And I feel like OG needs to calm down off her high horse for a minute and say, hey, while they're dealing with this on this season of this franchise, talk about it again. Like, we are always in a place to be educated about different things. And yes, we may have to explain it multiple times, but you're on national television, man, and you've expressed that you felt that you experienced colorism, and now people are coming and asking you, like, hey, did I do something? How did I make you experience this? And it's like she's brushing them off, like, do you even know? I mean, in my mind, that's what I'm thinking. Like, do you know? Can you explain it? Because if you can't, just say that. But don't keep attacking everybody that's asking you, hey, what did I do? Or when Jennifer is saying, I thought it was noble of Kristen to come over here and ask about it. Well, you never called me noble. Like, where is this coming from? And it's almost hard to not say the word aggressive or to say combative or things like that, because OG's not giving anyone any kind of space to understand what she's saying. And at the end of the day, you guys, comment below, let me know what you guys think. You can say what you want to say, but to me, if I did something to offend someone, I definitely want to know if I don't understand what it is that I did personally. Even if it was me and a group of people, I want to know for me personally what I did, and there's nothing wrong with that. And OG needs to understand that this to me is a bunch of bullshit. OG dismisses Jennifer. She's talking about she's coddling these women, and I don't think that it's coddling. I think it's an acknowledgement that, hey, I respect you for coming over and saying, hey, I hurt you, or I made you experience something bad. What did I do? And I just feel like OG is not giving these women this. And to me, I'm just gonna give my honest opinion. It comes off as rude. Like, I don't know. And my question is, at what point are we allowed to have our own opinions when it comes to things? Because yes, OG experienced this, but if she won't explain it to anyone, if I'm coming and I'm asking personally what I did and you won't tell me what it is because I didn't do the research for myself, I can't research what I did to OG. OG can only be the only person who can explain this to me, and she's not giving these women that. Now, Jennifer says she started to feel attacked, which right now I'm on edge because I'm like, is this going to be something that we have to worry about for the reunion? As a word that she shouldn't have used. And she is saying something that I really believe. It's like OG wants to hear what OG wants to hear. And OG's never gonna be able to hear it if she is not able to express what happened to these women. And that's point blank clear. That's as an adult, this is common sense. Like, if someone hurt you, they wanna know what they did. Because otherwise, she should have never even met with Kristen. And she should have never sat here for this conversation with Jennifer and Jackie and the new girls. She shouldn't have sat there for this because she doesn't want to hear it. But she sits there and she just dismisses everybody's trying to understand what's going on here. One of the new girls, because I don't know the part yet, but she said she had a teacher to sit her in the corner in her class for an entire year. And she was the only black girl in her class. And they're really empathizing with her because they want her to know she's not by herself. And I think as black people, we've all had these experiences. OG goes into a story about how a teacher told her that she's never going to amount to anything because she's black. Well, let me tell you something. I was in school, in my high school, my senior year, my school changed into academies. There was a technology academy, there was a business academy. And I can't think of the guy's name, the teacher's name, but he had a regular class and they had like a special program where like black kids were, they had like a Bank One Academy. And they like built businesses and they like opened up a store in the school. And I will never forget this. In our regular class, we had to build brochures. And so I did a brochure for Nike. And my mom at the time, we had just got a brand new computer. We had a color printer. And so I took my project home and I finished it. And I printed out a color. It was a really dope brochure. I wish I would have saved it. Well, I could have saved it. But I presented to the class the next day. And the teacher asked me for my project and used this for the Bank One Academy. But they wouldn't let me in because my grades weren't good enough. Now, mind you, I had a learning disability. I wasn't a book person. I am a visual person. So I learned different than everybody else. But because of that, they didn't have special classes for people at that time. So I missed out on a lot. Granted, now I have my own website business and graphic business. Something that I could have been taught in high school. I could have started this business a long time ago. But they left me out because I wasn't good enough because of my grades. And no one took the time to invest in my learning disability. So this is not something that's just preview to OG or the new girls. This is something that happens to black people all the time. So I guess when I'm hearing this colorism thing, or you're being set aside for different things, this is why I feel like, you know, educate these people. Because at the end of the day, this reminds me of Mama Joyce and the Lunchbox. And I feel like OG is taking out what that teacher did to her on everybody else in her life, and she needs to go to counseling and explore these things, because she's taking this out on everybody. At the end of the day, and if you guys want to rewind it, because I did a whole thing, and I don't think I'm going to do the video, but last season, OG was very nasty to, at least I know, Kristen, for at least the first 5 episodes. She exposed that Cece's husband didn't want her at the wedding. She exposed that Kristen's husband wasn't his dad wasn't his real dad. OG was very nasty in the beginning of the season. And then granted, after that, they all made peace. And then when it came back down to it, I forgot what happened, but it came down to Cece and Kristen needing to talk. OG kept inserting herself in that the entire time. So for them to feel that way, it's not because all of a sudden out of the blue, OG's aggressive, or OG is this bad person, or because OG looks like this, or her features are this or that. They were already upset with OG. Oh, and because OG inserted herself in Jackie and Evelyn's relationship as well last season. So all this stuff, like, if we're going to talk about it, let's talk about the entire thing. OG was very nasty last season. Yes, we all remember the last part of it, but there were many of episodes before that last part happened. And yes, Evelyn was wrong for running towards Kristen, towards Cece with the leaves in her hand, because they said it was bamboo, but it was like not even long enough to hang out of her hand. It was like you could only see the leaves from here to here. So it was just a lot, and I think that maybe people just forget about everything that happened because they feel like Evelyn is aggressive and all those things, which granted, Evelyn has been aggressive. So we can't say that she hasn't been. You know, I'm not going to say she hasn't been. We've seen Evelyn do a lot of bad things. But we've also cannot dismiss OG's behavior because Evelyn did bad things. So that's my thing. Like, we're going to hold everybody accountable. Hold everybody accountable, and not just Evelyn, because Evelyn did bad things, because Tammy was on that season last season, Jackie was on that season last season, they were all in that season, they've all done really bad things. But for some reason, because OG is calling out colorism, it's like, well, hold on now, like, we don't want to get into this. What do we do? Like, nobody knows what they say or do. And I understand why they don't want OG announced with them, because if I can be my own personal self, I don't want to be walking on eggshells on my vacation, period. And I think that's totally understandable. And you guys can say whatever you want to say. Comment below, let me know what you guys think. But I'm never going to be on a vacation where I got to be on eggshells around someone. Because if you come to me, because even when she was, when Kristen had walked up to Cece trying to talk to her, and it was Shawnee and it was OG, and Shawnee actually touched Kristen. Kristen thought it was OG. Kristen said, "Don't touch me, OG." All OG had to say was, "I didn't touch you." OG was like, "I didn't touch you. What if I did? Then what? Then what?" And she got up in her face. Like, are we not allowed to call that aggression? Like, are we not allowed to call a thing a thing? Because to me, I think that we're babysitting OG because everybody else has done bad things. And that's not fair, period. Like, at the end of the day, they all have done bad things. Let's call it what it is. Everybody's done bad things. And when OG walked away crying, I really feel bad for her because, again, I've experienced these things. And again, some of the other ladies in the house have experienced those same things too. So I definitely feel bad for OG because it is disheartening to feel like you're less than because people don't see the value in you, period. But that's not just a preview thing for just OG. A lot of us have experienced that stuff as well. If I come to you and I ask you what I did personally and you won't tell me because you're so over it and you don't have the patience to talk about it, well, at what time are you going to be ready to talk about it, OG? Because when you're ready to talk about it, then we are able to acknowledge the things that you have experienced, because until then, I may not know what you've experienced. Sometimes people do things they don't understand is offensive to other people. That's why you have conversations as adults, to talk about it so that you can get over it. Now, if I do it after that, then that's a problem. But until we have a conversation about what I've done to offend you, I cannot, and I don't understand what I did, or I don't know consciously, I cannot apologize or take responsibility. The only thing I can say is, if you felt that way, I apologize, which Kristen has said. And then OG said, I didn't feel like that. This is what I've experienced. So even in that, she still can't even be vindicated, because OG won't have a conversation. And at the end of this, it's just Jackie and Malaysia getting ready to have a conversation about what they've gone through, which again, you know, it points out the fact that you have to have a conversation. Otherwise, how do you know? And so I'm gonna leave it at that, guys. If you guys feel any type of way about anything that I said, please comment below. Let me know what you guys think. Again, if you want to join my crew, you know what to do. Subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, and share this video. Maybe some people feel how I feel. Maybe you don't. This is a non-judgmental zone. And I don't want people to feel like my opinion is like the end all be all. But also, like, if you don't like the show, you know, I understand that, but we're never going to have any shows if you guys keep wanting to take everything down because your favorite person has an issue with something that's going on the show. I don't like Atlanta Housewives this season. It's boring, but I'm not going to go online and say, cancel it, because after that, we're going to be like, we don't have any shows on television. Maybe they need to revamp it. Maybe you could take email, you know, the executives. Something, but canceling everything is not always the thing to do, guys. And with this show, I actually like Basketball Wives. You know, in my old video, I said, you know, I love Evelyn, I love Malaysia, even though I know they're wrong all the time. I still love it. I love watching them. It's like my escape from reality for an hour once a week. So you guys have to think about those things. Like, just because you don't like this show does not mean that everything that OG is saying is right. And because I like Evelyn, everything that Evelyn's saying is not right. But at the end of the day, it's about adults having a conversation. And so, again, comment below. Let me know what you guys think. I'm going to go ahead and get this edited, get this put up so you guys can get into this. And love you guys. And I will see you guys when I post my next video.